In this example, we are given that a free atom of iron emits K alpha X-ray of energy 6.4 kilo electron volt. And we are required to calculate the recoil energy of the atom, and the mass of iron atom is also given. In this situation, if we calculate the wavelength of emitted photon, this can be very easily calculated as the lambda is 12431 by 6400. And it is an electron volt, so directly we get the value of wavelength in angstrom. This will be 1.942 angstrom. This is the wavelength of the K alpha X-ray emitted. So we can see if there is an iron atom from which a photon of wavelength lambda is emitted, it always carries a momentum given as P is equals to H by lambda. Then to conserve momentum, the iron atom has to recoil with a speed say Vr in such a way that total momentum of the system will remain conserved. So we can write for conservation of momentum, here we can use MVr must be equals to H by lambda, because initially the iron atom was at rest. So in this situation, if we calculate the kinetic energy of recoiled atom, this kinetic energy can be simply written as P square by 2m, where P is the momentum, which is given by this expression. So this can be written as H by lambda square by twice the mass of iron atom. If we substitute the values here, in this situation we can easily get it as the value of kinetic energy is equals to, here the value of Planck's constant, we know it is 6.63 multiplied by 10 to power minus 34 divided by the wavelength, we know it is 1.942 into 10 to power minus 10 meter. Square of this we take, divided by twice the mass of iron atom, we can use as 9.3 into 10 to power minus 20 kilogram. So this will be the total energy given in joules. So to convert it into electron volt, we divide it by 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19. So this will be in electron volts. So on simplifying the numerical values, finally we will get 3.9 into 10 to power minus 10 electron volt. That will be the answer to this problem. This is the kinetic energy of recoiled iron atom.